Hello guys, we are in San Francisco. We're just taking some alpha pictures and right now we're walking around trying to find a cute street to take some pictures. It's a really pretty day. Unseasonably warm. Then after that, we are going to do some thrifting at Crossroads. We're targeting that pink house over there. Funny enough, I found the blazer that I'm wearing at this exact Crossroads, so I have high hopes. I can't decide if I like these Everlane jeans or not. They have this kind of slight flare. I don't have any jeans like that. I think I'm gonna get them. I kinda like them actually. Kinda like a 70s feel. The only thing is, like, it feels kinda loose here. Kinda like weird creasing going on here. But I can always get them tailored. Hello guys, we are in my bedroom and we're about to transform it into a photo studio because we are prepping for a Drifter Organic shoot. It's gonna be on Sunday, it's Friday now, and we're just getting prepping early. Once again, transforming my bed into a photo studio because that's what you do when you don't have a separate studio space. And the wall that gets a lot of light happens to be the wall that my bed is against. So we are going to do a little rearranging. There was that podcast episode on the expanded podcast. We're moving it this way.
I'm going to try to get it on its back side and then slide it.
Hey guys, I'm just about to go to the steam room for a little steam session. About a year and a half ago, I saw Ayurvedic doctors about my gut issues, and one thing that they said is that I have a lot of toxic buildup in my body, so I need to physically sweat profusely through all the layers of my skin. They gave me the option of doing hot yoga or going to the steam room, and since at that time I was literally throwing up my back, neck, and shoulders every other week, I chose to do the steam room. So I haven't been to the steam room in a while, but I've been doing regular acupuncture and taking baths and going to bed early and trying to do all this self-care stuff. And my body is just, my stomach has kind of felt like it's been in a funk lately. So we're gonna go to the steam room. Just got back from the event at Restore. It was super fun. Restore is a really cool concept shop in San Francisco that only carries online brands. so you can shop them in real life. I got these makeup removal towels from the brand Kish. I hope I'm pronouncing that right, but these are so cool. I've seen makeup removal towels floating around the interwebs, and it's been very intriguing to me because I usually just use tissues and olive oil or coconut oil to remove my makeup, but this is much more sustainable of an option. And what do I do with this? Wet makeup towel with warm water. Gently wipe away dirt, oil, and makeup in a circular motion. Rinse makeup towel and continue until step three until all makeup is removed. And follow with your favorite cleanser to deep clean. They also sent me this super cute spa headband. As a side note, my friend Katie made this adorable t-shirt. The proceeds of this t-shirt were to support the Australian bushfires from last month. And it says, I bought this t-shirt to help a koala, a real koala, and her friends. Probably something I would have worn in kindergarten. Aside from the fact that I think I overly wet the towel and got a bunch of black lint on my face, took off my makeup pretty well. I'm impressed. Turn off the camera. Welcome to edition 2,054,000 of We're Not Handy. We're just jerry-rigging this tape onto this crossbar here because I think we lost the screw. I don't know. Hopefully this will work. We're just about to shoot. This is Emily, and this is Maya. Trying to get a good drip. It's not coming out.
Oh, okay.
It's the drip that won't drop. Is he gonna pick you up?
Yeah.
And your Uber's gonna be over there? Okay, sweet.
Bye.
Well, bye.
Yeah.
See you.
Sure, I'll see you soon.
Yeah. Hello, guys. It is much later. I just finished my skincare routine and I am back in my bed. Feels super nice. The photo shoot went really well. It's always fun being behind the camera for me. When I first started my blog, it was a platform in which I shared different photos that inspired me. I really fell in love with fashion photography, and that kind of catapulted my interest in fashion. And then as the years went on, my blog evolved into more of my personal style, and I took outfit pictures, and then Instagram became a thing, and now my blog kind of lives more on Instagram, where I do little micro updates, more on the daily. So as much fun as it is being in front of the camera, it's fun to be behind the camera directing too. And I think that actually being both in front and behind the camera has given me different perspectives on how to be directed and be self-aware of my body and my movements, and how to be behind the camera and direct models, and how to communicate how they should move and what looks more natural. So I think it's made me a better, more well-rounded director overall. And I submitted a project for school today that was due, so I feel so good that I got that over with. Since I'm an online student, my weeks run Monday through Sunday, and Sunday night is often submission night. So for the rest of the night, it's just me, my juve, red light therapy, and a podcast, which has become my favorite way to wind down and transition into bedtime. So I think that's it for the day. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, leave a comment if you want to, press that notifications bell to be notified every time I upload, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye. I'm just about to submit my final project ever for school. Crazy.
Project C.
There she goes. Submitted.